Good afternoon. Welcome to social science class. Today's class, I would like to start with history first chapter, the French Revolution. I hope dear students, whatever I taught in the previous classes, you may enjoy. So, the same you are going to, but the history part is there now. Really, so we cannot enjoy. Instead of that, so we all feel something about the respective nations which we are going to learn in this academic year. So especially the French Revolution and even the Russian Revolution, and as well as so the Germany under the control of Hitler. So these are all the painful stories. So here, the French Revolution, this chapter we are going to start with an incident which was taken place in 14th July in 1789. And after that, so we are going to enter from the beginning of the French Revolution. So the basic, whatever the problems were created by the administrations, and also how the people they were reacted, and what were the new ideas and the new concepts were emerged among revolutionaries and contributed to the entire, not only the Europe, to the world, which were the new concept and ideas about a state or nation and so many things. See, let us discuss about that incident. So on the morning of 14th July 1789, so it was one of the remarkable day in the history of France country. So 14th July 1789, so what happened on that day morning? The city of Paris, so it was in a state of alarm. So we know that, because even till today, so the Paris, which was the capital city of the France country, so even so during that time also it has a significant role in the France country. Here the king had commanded troops to move into the city. This is what the story. So the king had commanded to military troops to move into the Paris city. So the rumors spread. So it was very common, even nowadays also it is a very common. So sometimes the rumors are played a vital role, and it was spread among the society in a different way, how they are going to express and their understanding. See, what about that rumors? So the rumors which was spread during the time, that is about, so the king, he would soon order the army to open fire upon the citizens. So this is what the rumors, so which was spread over the Paris city. Are you getting now? See, around 7,000 men and women, so they were all gathered in front of the town hall, and they were decided to form people's militia. People's militia. See, they broke into a number of government buildings in search of arms. See, what happened? So, on the morning of 14 July 1789, the city of Paris was in a state of alarm. Something was gone. And it was the alarm. So the king had commanded to troops to move into the city, to into the Paris city. And the same time the rumors spread that the king, he would soon going to order to the army to open fire upon the citizens. To open fire upon the citizens. And some 7,000 men and women, so they were gathered in front of the town hall, and they were decided to form so people's militia. So they broke into a number of government buildings, and in search they were searched for arms. So finally, what happened? a group of several hundred people. So they were marched towards the eastern part of the city and stormed the fortress prison. They were stormed the fortress prison. So the Bastille. The Bastille prison. So it was actually attacked by several hundred of people during this time. So where they hoped to find why they were attacked the Bastille prison. So because of they hope to find that for what? Hoarded ammunition. Hoarded ammunition. So in the armored fight that followed, the commander of the Bastille was killed and the prisoners also released through. There were only seven of them. Only seven of them. They were released. See, and the Bastille was hated by her. So how many they were there? How many prisoners were there? So only seven prisoners, they were inside of the Bastille prison. But the main purpose of the people, so why they were attacked and there too. And they hope to get, to find hoarded ammunition. And so they were killed. The commander of the Bastille prison. So what happened? So the people, they were killed, commander of the Bastille, and even they were released. How many? Totally there were only the seven prisoners. So even though the Bastille was hated by all the people, so because it stood for despotic power of the king. It stood for despotic power of the king. That shows that the power of the king, the Bastille prison. So that's what, so this was hated by everyone in the France country. And the fortress was demolished and its stone fragments were sold in the markets to all those who wished to keep a souvenir of its destruction. What a nice situation this year. What they were done? So they were killed the commander of the Bastille. And they were released the around seven prisoners also. And the Bastille prison was hated by everyone. So there was a reason. Why? Because the Bastille prison, so it was stood for the despotic power of the king. And the fortress also, so demolished, and the stone fragments, the piece of the stones and the fragments were sold in the markets to all those who wished to keep a souvenir of its destruction. That's what. See, the days that followed saw more rioting both in Paris and the other part of the country, in the France. So the most people, they were protesting against the high price of bread. This is what. Why these common people, so they were right against, so they were involved in this writing against the administration. So why they were struggle against, why they were revolt against the Louis administration means, so because this is what the main reason. So the common people, the poor class people, the middle class people, so they were struggling to live their life. So especially the high price of the essential things, including the food items. So most of the people, they were protesting against the high price of bread. And much later, what happened? So when historians looked at it back upon this time, so they saw it as the beginning of a chain of events that ultimately led to the execution of the kings in, king in the France country. Though most people at the time did not anticipate this outcome. So how and why did this happen? About this we are going to learn. So I hope that how the Bastille prison, it was attacked by and it was stormed by the common people, may understood the reason also. Now let us discuss about the next topic. So this is what a very most important thing, that is about the structure of the French society. Then already I told that in the beginning. So the people, so they were revolt against because of the high price of bread. That means the common people, the poor class people, the middle class people, so they were all suffering to get their essential, to even to feed their, they were struggled anything like for a single piece of bread during Louis' administration. See why and how this war happened and how the new ideas and the new, the revolutionaries' activities were started in this country that we are looking. So the main thing, so we should know that the structure of the French society. See, in 1774, Louis XVI, so came from the Bourbon family of king. So he was ascended the throne of France. It is clear. So in 1774, Louis 16, so was came from the Bourbon family. He was ascended the throne of France. So was belongs to the Bourbon family, and in 1774, so 16th Louis, he came to power as the king or the emperor of the France country. See, 16th Louis, so he was 20 years old. He was a young one. He was the young one who came to power in the age of 20 years only. And he was married to the Austrian princess, so whose name was Mary Antoinette. Mary Antoinette, so who, she was a wife or queen of the France country. Understood? No. So he was married. So the Austrian princess Mary Antoinette. See, when he was 20 years old, so he was married to the Austrian princess Mary Antoinette. See, upon his accession, the new king found an empty treasury. So this is what actually bad time for the 16th Louis also. Why? Because now when he came to power, so during that time, so he was found an empty treasury. The treasury was completely empty. Then you can imagine, so how before the coming Louis, so how the remaining kings, they were drained completely the state, I mean the France treasury. It was an empty treasury when he came to power. We all of you knows that if there is no treasury, if there is no accounts, if there is no resources, so the kings, they cannot run and they cannot provide the facilities for its citizens. So it is a very common thing also, even till today also. Okay, now what happened? So why it's an empty treasury it was? So there were many reasons. So because the first thing that, so long years of war had drained the financial resources of France. So long years, continuously they were involved in wars. So because of that wars, continued wars, for a long time, for long years, so completely what happened? So the financial resources drained. The financial resources of the France country drained because of the long time war. Are you getting? And added to this was the another one thing, that the cost of maintaining the extravagant court of the immense palace of Versailles. The maintenance of the palace Versailles. A Versailles palace and a maintain maadbeku antandre, so whoever it may be, the extravagant ellarana maintain maadbeku antheladre, so it is so expensive. It was so expensive. So why? Because no, so the cost of maintaining, so this is also very much important, the maintenance of the extravagant court at the, especially the palace of Versailles. Because it is one of the huge palace which were required a lot of members as a workers or the courtesans. See, under Louis XVI, what happened? So France helped. This is the another one reason. So the first thing that already because of involved in the long year wars, so the financially the resource of the country drained. And the second thing that the maintenance of extravagant immense of that, especially the court of the immense of the palace of Versailles, that's also too cost. And the, during the same time only, so under Louis, so 16th, what happened? So France, it was helped to the 13 American colonies. This you have to keep in your mind. The America, I mean, so the France also, so helped 13 American colonies to gain their independence from the common enemy that we all of you knows that even for them also and before 1947 for us also, the Britain. So the Britain was common enemy for US and as well as for France also. So that's what happened now. So here the France, it was helped. So the American, especially 13 American states. So not only one or two, so the 13 American colonies, so to gain their independence from the common enemy about Britain, so they were helped. See, the war added more than a billion lives, more than a billion lives. Actually, that is a the unit of currency, so which was discontinued in 1794, which is called as lire. Which is called as lire. Understood now? Lire means that is actually the unit of currency which was discontinued, stopped in 1794. So here, yeah, during this time, so what happened? A billion lives to be at debt that had already risen to more than 2 billion lives. They had taken loan from other countries. Estitu makla. So 1 billion lives did the loan. No, adi enagitte antu hedre. So that was began to more than, it was already what happened? More than 2 billion lives. So lenders who gave the state credit, now they were start to began to charge 10% interest on loans. Those who are given the loans, so the money lenders, so they were start to rise and even they were start to began to charge interest, that is about the 10% of the interest also. I hope dear students you are able to follow me. See, now because of this what happened, so the government of France, the Louis administration, so it was very clear that it is in economic, it was in economic crisis, the condition of the state and then even the empty treasury. Now after that, dear student, the French government was obliged to spend an increasing percentage of its budget on interest payments alone. So what to do? There is no way. See, to meet its regular expenses such as the cost of maintaining army, court and even running government offices and to give salaries for the office bearers also and even to run the educational institutions, universities and now what happened? So the government can run all this, the maintenance of army, it's very much important and there is no way we should maintain the army also. Understood now? And even the court and even the running government offices also and university, these are all actually essential for the government to run anywhere in any situation and even in any conditions also. Now to maintain, to balance, so the government was forced to increase the taxes. The government was forced to increase the taxes, so yet even this measure would not have suffice. Even so, they were increased the taxes, they were forced the taxes, but the thing is that, so even this measure also would not have suffice. That is not enough, that is also not sufficient. Then French society in the 18th century, it was divided into three estates. It was divided into three estates, and only members of the third estate paid taxes. So this is what the another one, so problem which was faced by the rulers, because all citizens, they were not paid taxes during that time. So to run the government, to maintain the government offices and universities and all the maintenance of the court, so everything, so to balance this, so the government was forced to increase the taxes. But even though after increasing also, so it was not sufficient and it was not enough to maintain the government expenditure. So why? Because during 18th century, during Louis administration, so the society, it was divided into three classes, and here, so among all these, so only the members of the third estate, so they paid taxes. So about the French society, we are going to discuss in the next class. Thank you. Have a nice day.